The very first question one will ask, who birthed Danso Merit Choir? My answer would be God. But we all know that God always does things through man. And he always does it and gives it to only one person. So he gave it to one person. He gave the vision and the dream to one person. And that is Kwame Krenzel, also known as DJ.
He was the choir organizer. So at a point, he handed over to me. So I was an organizer for a long while, carrying combos, doing all sorts of groundwork, packing chairs and all that. We've been there, we've done all that.
He was a friend to Ebenezer Adam Bebe. Adam can play the keyboard and can teach. So he shared the vision with Adam. And then they all went like, oh, it's a good idea. But do you know something? We don't have people to start the whole project with. So I know a guy who has a lot of choirs. He teaches in a lot of choirs. So Adam told DJ that they should come and see us. So we met. Our first meeting was at Dansuman Post Office, close to the Melcom. We sat down, they shared the idea and the vision with me. I said, okay, fine. I have people. I can make some calls, even today, so that we tell them when we are meeting. So this is the class we found ourselves in after moving from that place. This place is spacious and has better chairs and tables where we felt very comfortable. Sopranos were always sitting in front of us, altos here, tenors here, and then the basses over there. And then we had our directors in front, teaching us all the songs for our programs.
I think I'll give credit to Adam because he was quite disciplined. And then the guys too were too also enthused. As if they didn't give chances at all. And then with the discipline coming from Adam, I think he makes sure that I think during rehearsal they do the right thing with the dictions, pronunciation of words, tone itself. So when you meet them and then having shows with them, you're okay to go because they've already done their own EQ settings. They've already done their own, you know, parts arrangements, and then you're good to go.
The sound of the choir is unique. I mean, even when you hear the choir from day one till now. So that's what I'm saying, that is kind of natural because people come in, go out and all that. But once they come to the choir, we change even the way they sound. So the whole choir sound is good. It's peculiar to the choir. Even when you don't know the choir sing and you hear the sound, you can even align that, okay, this is Danso Merit Choir, this is DYC Choir. And that has been since day one till now.
there's a particular, a peculiar voice they have. I'm very sure it started from onset and they've kept it. And I kept hammering on it that is what they have. And that is what will attract people to them. They lose that and they are just like any other group. And it is so unique. If you have love for music and you appreciate choral music is all about the voice. I mean, the instrumentation is not much. I mean, whatever backing they have, accompaniments all they have, is about the voice. And DYC has that peculiar voice. You love to hear them. Even if they are two, the sopranos, if they are two, and you have just a one auto backing and the tenor comes in, they will sing as if the mass choir singing. And the harmony is unique to the extent that tone, I'm very sure they sing the same piece. They have the same scoring so far as the music is concerned. But they come out with something that makes them unique. And I think that's what has kept me with them. So at a point when it's losing out, it's getting out of, I insisted that they keep that one.
What makes DYC rather unique and different is not really in the tone of the music. Because if you study music, you realize that tones can be learned, they can be adapted. So that really is not what it is. I think it's in the organizational skill that they have to put together the music. And that is quite different. The rearrangement of the music, the sound is completely different when you rearrange a certain kind of music. And for me, they've done that so brilliantly, and I don't see many choirs doing that. So they have the capacity to take a song and make the song their own in terms of how it is rearranged and redone. And that is what makes DYC DYC.
DYC was known for a brighter tone. Tone, when you talk about tone color, DYC had a tone. When DYC stands to sing, it was different. You could compare it to any other choir that was in existence at that time, and even now.
The first thing I noticed about the choir was that it's a very unassuming choir. Unassuming in the sense that it's like having a dynamite. When you see a dynamite lying down, it looks harmless. It looks very simple till it is lit, and then there's an explosion. It's that it's a very powerful weapon. That's how I see DYC. Very, very unassuming choir. So you hear them sing, you may underrate them. So you hear the choir perform, I mean, you could see anything about them.
Thank you.
one of the traits that make Dansoman Youth Choir very distinct is their spirit of perseverance. You know, the choir has passed through a lot. You know, I know the choir, so I know some of the challenges they've passed through.
The choir around 2015, 2016 were struggling. Struggling for a number of reasons. I think the major one would have been funding, on how to cope with the pressures of being a choir in terms of the young ones coming for rehearsals and having concerts. And also there was at that time a certain leadership crisis as well, which almost derailed the choir. And that was probably the most trying time for them around 2016-2017.
I think one fantastic thing about DYC is how we publicize our events. And I remember we've the whole Ghana is aware we are doing a concert at
Banquet Hall.
But a lot of them,
but they will not mind you because they've heard Sekwa Nebu. Yeah, and it's a challenge we're going through. Everybody says, Carnegie.
So, for 2016, I think the groundwork, I was on the marketing events team with Aaron and the choir master. And I think it started from Ghana, right? When we went in to have them try to get a deal with them to handle our production. I think everything summed up to around 32,000. We didn't have words. How to get the money, we didn't know. But we went ahead to confirm our agreement with them that.
And we didn't have a venue as at then.
We didn't have a venue.
We were pushing Bangwe to pay. And right to the event, we were sent a warning that if we don't make our down payment, that will be the release for us on the day of leaders. That was like the day before the concert.
I remember the man was like, Miko Fio, Mamba, watching a movie. The thing is,
I remember I have to move it then director to make payments
at JOT's house.
Yes, at JOT. I think I even went there. Making payments,
we had to do at the part payment, right? Yeah. That was 15k, and we had like 5k. And we had called JOT that we were on our way, and like, I'm waiting. Are you bringing the money? Say, yes, sir. I remember I got there, and then chairman had to. I was a bit scared, so I stood by my car. And he went in and then gave the money to JOT and counted the money, 5,000. The guy just chucked, watching, he's like, but this is not 15,000. Yeah, he didn't say anything, he just walked off. I think he's one of the most fantastic guys in the world. When we were coming, we were arrested too.
Yeah,
I didn't have my license.
I think it's been a quest of faith.
At a point also, there were misunderstandings. We met them, we had a discussion with them, we told them exactly what it is, we told them the need for a change in face, in terms of name, and all that, the evolution in terms of Dansoman Youth Choir coming to DYnamiC, I mean DYC, DYnamiC and all that. We had two meetings at two different venues, and I realized that, look, those who will stay, and those who will be going. We've had another detailed meeting, and there were misunderstanding, and finally, some had to leave. In fact, almost 2-3 groups had come out of DY, the original Dansoman Youth Choir, yes. I know of one of the organizers who later on met with his own group also, who has also left. But you see, the strength of a group lies in the fact that when others are leaving, the group still stands. And it brings come out some sense of tenacity. And the faith of the group, or the people who are staying in, tells you that they want to stay with the group.
Family is family. Even when you move out from Ghana and go to overseas, you still remember that there is a family that you belong to. So you still come back to it. Yes, there was a breakaway, but I would have to give thumbs up to this guy, Nilante. Yes, he stood on his grounds and then made sure that things worked. Because he was also part of it. He saw what the earlier people did. And so he realized that, why should I let this thing crumple just like that? I will hold on to it.
Because he was a youth, and then, you know, guys, sometimes when you're with them, you also see the energy that they want to make it work. And by grace, we are 15 years.
It's been a wonderful journey. I think that apart from my mother's birthday, they were at my mother's funeral, and as the treasurer of the Ghana Journalist Association, DYC has also ministered at one of our awards ceremony, and then they have also ministered at one of our Thanksgiving services at the Ghana International Press Center. And so for me, it's been a worthwhile journey. I've come to fall in love with DYC, and they are going places, and I'm happy to be part of DYC.
There's this commitment with the members of the choir that you can't get anywhere. They will hold, no matter what happens, there have been ups and downs in the choir, but these guys have held on to the choir and pushed it to this level. We thank everyone, and I wish that there will be greater heights. We've done it before, we keep doing, and the opportunities still keep coming.
But then joining DYC has taught me that even outside the main activity of the group, there's a certain way you can show affection to the other people in the group that will make the group have a greater sense of unity. So I think that's the main thing that I would say that has changed or improved since I joined DYC.
I've learned to appreciate people, no matter where they're coming from. Each person has something to offer. That's what I see in this choir. I mean, I've seen from DYNamiC choir to DYC choir. Each person has something to offer. So you don't just push someone off because they're coming from this background or this background. Like, they have something to offer. So you give the person the opportunity to speak or to see their mind.
And one thing I also have noticed about the group is their mental fortitude and their willingness to go forth and achieve whatever it is. It is one thing I hope it never dies from the choir, regardless of them not having sponsorships, regardless of them not having a lot of mileage. I think they should just keep going, keep up the good work and just keep going. I think when the light shines on you, you'd be happy you went that way.
DYNamiC choir, or the DYC choir, has been the best choir I have experienced since 2013. 15 years down the lane, they are still one of the best you could ever find in Ghana. Their confidence, their loyalty, the friendship that binds each other, and even for the fact that they were able to nurture us, the euphonic choir, I think they have done extremely well, and it is going to really take them far.
Because of DYC, I learned to be with people, I learned to interact with people, I learned to feel free with people. I learned not to offend people, but I mean, do what has to be done. So I think it has also improved my interrelationship with people.
I'll read a quote from St. Augustine's, which says, "When large numbers of people share their joy in common, the happiness of each is greater because each adds fuel to the other's flame." This evening, I really want to congratulate DYC for such a milestone. 15 years as a choir is never easy. So I'm always happy when groups get to that age. And I wish them well in their journey ahead. I wish they go far beyond Africa, go all to all countries, go take the name of Ghana high, so that in the end, we all enjoy and share a common goal as one group and as a union, as a choir.
I want to promise them one thing, that insofar as I continue to be a minister and continue to be alive,
I'll be ready to be part of them in the history, in the years ahead of them. The history yet to be made. Nobody knows the future, but we believe and trust that we take one day at a time, one month at a time, one year at a time. And from all that they've gone through and still keep on going and keeping, means that the future will be bright for them. And based on that, I can't look through the crystal ball, but I can look through within myself as a priest and an historian or student of history to predict that DYC, DYNamiC Choir, will go far in many ways. And I can see that in the next 5-10 years, it will be a group to watch. People will love to listen to them. They will not just sing, they will minister unto people through choral music. And when they sing, it will not be different from angels singing, because there will be a force behind, which is the power of the Holy Spirit, through the lyrics of their songs that will touch hearts.
Well, going forward in the future, I'm looking forward to seeing them as a proper choir, paid up with their members, looking at the business side of what they do in order to get to that point. And then I believe that they've gone past the localizing of their music. It's way over time that they should be traveling around the world like other choirs do. And that's what I'm looking forward to, the next 15 years of the choir. For me, I'll just wish them an amazing 15 years. It's been good. It's been hard. It's been difficult. There's been challenges. But if they've been able to go through that 15-year period, I believe that the next 15 years is just going to be amazing.
You know, one beautiful thing that they've done that marvels me is the rebranding. You know, because rebranding is always done by serious companies, and everyone that wants to move to the next level, you know. So from Dansuman Youth Choir to DYNamiC Choir is an excellent name, and it excites me because, yes, they are indeed DYNamiC, because when you are listening to their repertoire, they have, I mean, variety of repertoire. I mean, from Ghanaian choral highlights to Ghanaian art music, to Western classical, to chants, to orthodox music and all that. I mean, and it's a very DYNamiC choir. So yeah, the name DYNamiC Choir is really a great name, and I think it was a good choice, and I love it so much. And once again, congratulations DYNamiC Choir for your 15th anniversary, and we are all part of it. We will all be there to support. Chat, we love you all.
With us,